Ladies and gents, this is the moment you've waited for. Welcome to another episode of the Council of Six, a weekly Dungeons & Dragons campaign fraught with all the drama and peril that will take your breath and steal your mind. My name is Jay Longaro, your DM for the night, and on this campaign, we will be using Tyranny of Dragons, which tells an epic story across two adventures in which Hoard the Dragon Queen is the first. Unlike our other streams, we won't be commenting on your comments while we are in play as to remain immersed in the story, but please still engage and comment as we go along. During the breaks, we will go through the comments and interact with you all, because at the end of the day, we are presenting this for your enjoyment. But without any further ado, are you ready to leave all that's real behind? Because there's something breaking at the brick of every wall that's holding all that you know. So tell me, do you want to go to the Council of Six?
Oh, there's no video. I've been caught off guard.
Yeah. No.
Because OBS 28. Fuck virtual camera plugin, so I can't share
right.
In the damn thing. I mean,
well, I'm just on the YouTube and the Twitch, and it's a little bit behind, but good enough. We can hear the sound. I can figure it out.
Yeah, but we're back for another Council of Six. Sans Sophie today. Sophie's internet is down, so she'll be joining us again next week. Bryce is here too. He's just hiding.
Don't worry, guys.
Literally, first of all, a bard cannot wear that. Okay.
Oh my god, that's fantastic.
A bard cannot wear heavy.
Not only that, it's here. It was gone. If you talk about it later, it's like it happened in a dream.
There you go. All right. So, how was you guys?
I've been holding on to that.
I'll tell you how my week was, and I spoke to Mickey about this earlier because I really needed to double check and make sure that I had my feelings in check before I brought this forward. How did none of y'all motherfuckers tell me amongst all of my coworkers that this shit here is just blatantly obvious on the stream at all times? No one said anything. You just let this happen?
What? You're gray?
Yeah, my gray? Fucking grays.
What the fuck, dude? Come on, man.
He is
like, I have more in this thing than I.
What, you want to diet? I can diet for you.
No, I can't diet. But I will. I would have done a lot more speaking like this had I known that it was literally so loud it was screaming at everybody.
You can't do that because first of all, you have the camera down here. You have the camera down here, so it's like this.
Well, it was even worse whenever I sat up. I feel like I'm sitting in a laundry basket like kids do. I've got my chair so low, but it's been so high that literally almost everything I've been has just been like, "Hey guys, how's everybody doing today?" Like, I've been throwing it at them.
That's when you raise up the laptop or cam, not try to lower.
See, Mickey told me the same thing before, but my desk is already such a mess that I can't bring myself to my laptop.
Put it on top of books.
I know this type of thing because I am very vain, and I know that the best angle is just up here.
Yeah, looking down.
I don't know if you can tell. From
you don't need to. You don't want to show the chins.
When you're, I don't know if you can tell no from matter. Like my general outlook and like the slobbiness and the homelessness, but I have never taken a selfie. So
the Zach Galifianakis-ness of it all.
I don't do selfies either, so whatever. I don't care.
No. People don't even know me and her together because
I will be streaming Fanac like this for the remainder of the campaign.
It's not literally that I take selfies though. It's not. It's that it's just I thing, taught via Zoom for the longest time where I was the only one with my camera on.
Understood.
All of my students had their cameras off. And so what else am I supposed to look at except my own face? And eventually I was like, you know what? I like it. We're good. So that's kind of how that happened.
Yeah.
I would have liked to have been there during like the week or two that you were like prospecting that, where like one session you're here, one session you're here, one session you're here, until you figured out where you needed to be.
Yeah, it was so like, I mean, I could like, you know, like over here.
And the camera breaks.
I had it a good
all of a sudden,
spot.
Fuck. I touched it one too many times.
Rocks fall, everyone dies.
Now I've messed up.
You want to laugh? Remember I was just talking about Twitch about how only the top streamers get that where you could change the settings. Yeah. On mine right now, I'm actually looking at, I can actually change the settings from 1080 to 720 to 480. How did I get so lucky all of a sudden?
To have that in there. Maybe just to play with it enough you could do it.
Celebration is in order. After 2 years of having Twitch and making a little bit in the beginning, after 2 years, it finally hit the $100 threshold that I got to pay out after 2 years of having a Twitch channel.
Nice.
Thank you to all three quarters of you who watch us and allowed us to make it this far, where Lungo finally made $100.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, my channel on YouTube used to have pretty good viewership, but it, like, my dad died and I stopped streaming and... No. I mean, the D&D stuff was always low.
And then this happened, and everyone left.
No, don't underestimate the power of silver foxes.
You're just jealous of the helmet.
there's nothing wrong with that. I feel like one day Salt and Pepper, it's going to be a vibe. It's going to be a look. Somebody spilled salt.
Oh,
I'm on my way.
Salt. Or something up, some other white substance that just like there's something down. About Mary going it's, on here.
It's the one shot. It's the one shot before I got my lips around it again. Anyway, let's play D&D.
See, Dylan's taller, so it didn't go high enough to hit his hair. It stopped his shit.
I don't know how tall you think I am.
Oh my god! This past weekend,
for the sake of the joke, Dylan. Take it for the sake.
This past weekend, I helped film a promo video for the haunted maze that I scare at in the month of October, and part of it the like guy filming was like, okay, like I need you to drool, and I was like, what?
Okay.
What?
Because
like it's like asylum themed, yeah. And so I was like staring at a TV, and it was like, I need you to drool, and I was like, I don't know if I can do that,
buddy. You're gonna have to work harder than that.
All right, last time, console 6 or the Dragon Queen, our adventurers had made it to Daggerford, and shenanigans went down in the city. They did get some information from Helmick, finding out how apparently the cult is doing some strange experimentation with the eggs of metallic dragons. Similar to what Planar Theory has learned about stuff that's happened in another realm called Kryn, and making beings called Draconians, which, unlike half dragons, or unlike Dragonborn in Faerun, do not hate dragons, but rather aspire to be like them and follow orders. They also learned that Cassian had been in a city at one point and was headed east towards Sacomber as well. And what else did you guys find out here? They found out about the cult going north, and you guys knew that already.
Tommen is a member of the...
Oh, yeah, Tommen is a member of the Harpers, but the only ones that Harper. Knows that is Thanic and Mal.
No, I think we told the rest of the party.
I'm sure you did.
Right before we went to...
the contact, yeah.
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 Yep.
And you guys are stuck, yeah. And you guys are in Daggerford for at least a week, mm-hmm. with it not moving out until, I thought I marked it on the calendar.
There's a festival.
The 3rd of Marpanoth, yes, the High Harvest Tide, the Festival of Harvest Tide, is...
When is that happening?
Now, it's like its own month in the calendar, three days from now.
Okay, I see that.
Yeah. Okay. There's a name for that in calendarology. Is that a word? Is calendarology a word?
No.
It is now, by golly.
Intercalendary month. That's what it's called. An intercalendary month. That it's basically like its own month between months. That's kind of separate from the rest. So it's like a... But it's just one day for the festival.
Horology is the study of that's measuring time.
Oh, there we go.
H-O-R-O-L.
Yeah, yeah. As opposed to what went down at the Lucky Lady.
Yeah, Mal is
the horology that went down there.
Mal is a horologist here, guys. He's an expert in this field.
Oh.
And that was part of the shenanigans, too, at the Lady Luck, which everyone found out was a strip club. And lots of stuff went down. Now, Thanic managed to leave early for the night and cuddled with the stag. Mal and Stevie ended up getting into an orgy with another couple for money. Fleur basically wanted to get some and somehow managed to pull the hottest whatever in the place and took out the room.
I believe they
said Tiny.
They look like Ferulam.
Yes, that is indeed what Sophie said.
Tiny, very depressed and downtrodden, constantly kicked off the poles, unable to do something, basically went home with the first lounge lizard that said hello. Literally, lounge lizard. it took her back. So now, time is changing. It's the next morning. It's around 7:30. The following morning, after all this, everyone is making their walks of shame. Walks of shame.
The 29th of the fading month.
Now it's the 28th. It's the 28th of the aliens. I already changed it before we started.
You already changed it. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. It was the 27th that the shenanigans went down.
Stevie is not doing like any sort of shameful walking.
Right.
She got 40 gold.
Oh, Thanic, you weren't here when I explained to everyone. If you look at the map now, there's those little green banners. Those are shops. So if you double click on that, those are shops you can actually shop at. If you double click on it, it shows you the inventory and you can actually purchase things right through there when you go in there. If anyone is going to purchase things, I would appreciate going into shop and doing a role play, not just clicking on it like it's an Amazon cart.
you have to click the little bookmarky thing that shows you the quest.
The little green, looks like a sign, like a green banner sign hanging.
You've heard of red flags? It's actually a green flag.
I don't know what that is, but that's okay.
Trying to map, there's like four of them. There's like four or five of them over certain buildings.
So how do you see what's in there, though? Because I can
double
click on it. It tells me the name.
Double click it.
Okay, I see.
I may need to reload. That's okay.
I want to buy an orc testicle.
I was waiting for someone to find that. Here, here's a
helmet. I don't know how the hell you did that.
Mickey found the balls.
Is that surprising?
It's a D&D version of Rocky Mountain oysters. It's just orcs.
Apparently not Mal's balls, because he has a thing about.
Notice splits. They're listed under consumables.
Is it like Rocky Mountain oysters?
Yeah, that's what I said. Like Rocky Mountain oysters.
The worst part about it is there's actually Rocky Mountain oysters because there's cows in this game.
Yeah, but the oysters are attached to them, so
there are no Rocky Mountains in this.
No, I'm pretty sure there's some mountains with rocks on them.
Hey, that's where I come from.
So yes, it's the following morning. And Dobby has still been missing this whole time.
Since Sophie's not here, we don't have to pretend to care.
Oh no, now, sweetie, Dobby.
We should probably go regroup with Thanic.
You gotta unpause the game.
Nope.
Oh yeah.
Don't do that. I don't want any part of this today. Thanic's not ready to be sad.
Which by the way, Tiny... at some point during shenanigans occur, if it's at all possible, Mal is going to try and lift the purse off of one of the people he slept with before he leaves.
Fucking no.
Yeah, you can roll for that. By the way, I'm trying to remember where you guys purchased the rooms. Was it at the Silver Flood Inn?
I think it's wherever I'm at, is it not?
No.
I think
no, because you're not sleeping at the Happy Cow Tavern. That's where you guys ate. That was at the Chuck E. Cheese-like place.
Oh.
Chuck E. Cheese.
It was basically...
I missed that completely.
Yeah, I think it was the Silver Flood Inn, 22.
I think you're correct.
All the way up here. So Thanic would actually be cuddling with the stag up here.
I mean, don't mind if I do. It's a good night's sleep.
11 on a sleeping target.
Can I give him a... are they asleep?
Hmm.
If not, Stevie would like to somewhat distract them.
Mal's only trying sleeping. It when they're sleeping. Yeah, Mal's only
he
trying when they're sleeping.
Sleeping.
Okay.
Which would that just be advantage then, or how would you want to do that?
Let me see. No, yeah, I would. Yeah, it would. If they're sleeping, you'd be rolling with advantage.
Okay, let me roll one more time then. So 11 or.
Oh!
11. It's 11.
Mm-hmm. It is indeed 11.
I'm going to have to roll against this.
What is the
pattern? All right, yeah, no. Whatever. Yeah, I just use a commoner and just use the. Mm-hmm. But yeah, they still rolled shitty. So yeah, you managed to steal it. And let's do a little dicey dice roll here to see if you find anything in there.
Just a lot of use. All right,
so this roll here is gold. Let me make that viewable. All right, so you find 2 gold.
Uh-huh.
Or actually, that's right. That's silver, not gold. Silver.
Oh, that's silver?
Yeah, that's silver.
They spend all their gold on us.
And the gold, four gold. 4 gold and 2 silver.
Ooh.
You found a pretty wealthy drunkard sleeping randomly somewhere on the street.
In the strip club. They were still in the strip club.
Yeah, this is the person who is we slept with.
Yeah, I left.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
I left with
the lizard. you know what? I need you to roll a constitution saving throw, Tiny. Actually, before we do that, let me try to add it for you because I like how I can. Why half my road disappear again? Never mind. Go ahead, just roll your constitution saving throw.
Should I get there? We go. Got it. Okay.
I don't see it.
Hey. There
19.
You go. Good rolls.
22.
Plus the 22. Oh, shit. You took it like a champ.
No, I didn't. I already have it all planned out. What happened?
Nah, yes. You rolled the 22. Yes. Constitution 22.
I get to choose, man. What happens then since I got 22 Constitution.
All right. But but here's the thing. With a 22 Constitution, that means there's no pain involved. There's no.
Yep. I got it. And I woke up. And, well, Thanic's going to wake up, but I'm going to be still in my panties and bra and snuggling and Tiny and my little fairy around in his cloak. So still? I ended up sleeping. I ended up finding him and falling asleep with him.
I would think those came off at some point.
They can ask me later what happened. Nope. Absolutely not.
He just slid it across?
Absolutely not. I woke up and I am with him and they can ask me later if they want to know. But I am still in the same shape. I am still in the same shape I was when I left. I get to pick since I got 22.
Yes.
But I am with Anik in my little fey, and I am sleeping with him.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like snuggled up in his neck.
By the way,
you have
you're laying there, Thanic, like this on your back, and you have the stag snout right here and Tiny Gorilla right here.
I've been in worse situations.
Basically, she took it like a champ, and then before passing out, went to find Thanic and fell asleep near him. Is what happened.
You can ask if you want to know.
No, it was the aftercare. Wake up. Culling with Thanic was the aftercare.
The first thing that I look to is the stag. Boy, you're closer than I thought you'd be.
I don't know what sound a fucking stag makes.
Goodness. What happened to you?
She's still asleep. Are you waking her up?
I mean, I'm not going to try very hard. The booming voice of an 8-foot-6 monster is not enough to wake you. I'll just sort of scoot you over towards a little bit farther down the haystack. Hey. Just like waiting on a small child, I'll wait until the whining stops, and then I'll slowly get up. It's very strange. Well, I seem to be alone.
As Mal's walking out of the Lucky, wherever they slept, with a coin purse from one of the people he just banged.
Yeah, absolutely.
Danik, I'm hungry.
That doesn't seem very sportsman-like, man.
I was just going to get food for everyone else. Settle down. And I'll.
Can I come? I want to come.
I mean, you can't go into a place of business like that. You will have to.
I want to come.
You can't go into anything like that. You have to look up.
I want to come.
Put a shirt on or you'll stay in the hay.
I don't have one.
Well, that seems to be a problem more for you than it is for me.
I want to come. Up.
Do you do this to those two as well? You can't go in there without a shirt on.
I don't have one. Up.
I mean, I am literally at a loss for how I can fix this.
Up.
At this point, I'm sure Thanic sees Stevie and Mal strolling up.
Hey, you! No, thank you. Do you have her clothes?
That would be a good time to mention Miller's Dry Good does sell a variety of clothing. They're actually listening.
If you don't have any clothes for her, I'm afraid mine are far too large. And she can't go into an inn this way. I'm gonna go and get everyone breakfast. You take care of this.
But I wanna come.
Look, it's Mickey, or not Mickey, it's Stevie, or whatever the fucking Centaur name is. She will help you get dressed. Then you can come.
Oh, sweetie, we need to get you some clothes. You can't go around, in your all together.
I look fine. It's like bathing suit. I look fine. Take me with you.
No, you see, people will have questions. We should get you some clothes. They'll think I'm not taking care of you.
But they were dressed like this at the other place we were at, and it was fine.
Yeah, but that's
very much not the same kind of establishment.
Yeah,
we can just go back and go there because I think my dress is somewhere there.
They didn't have food though. We'll get you a new dress. Are you so you're in your tiny fairy form right now?
Yeah. Yeah, she's still a fairy.
So then he druid crafts a flower and like fashions the petals into a little dress for Tiny.
Yay! That's so pretty. Thank you.
That's pretty
yay.
Fucking cool.
Oh, my. Stevie.
I may have good ideas sometimes. It's okay.
She immediately goes over to you.
I need 4 normal person meals, and then if you could take like a small pinch of everything and just like put it on the table next to us.
Matter of fact, give yourself an inspiration point for that one.
Yeah.
The first inspiration or second? I don't know.
I don't know.
I think you gave
me inspiration when I fought Cyanrath, but I don't think it's been DM granted.
I always forget that I have that as like gifts, and I always forget that it's there, and I gotta remind myself sometimes.
Where in Forge, how can I give myself inspiration?
I believe there's a thing on your sheet for it. Let me see.
Don't see it. Oh, there it is.
Yeah. There you go.
Found it.
Yeah, inspiration box. Okay, I see it.
I get inspiration. Yeah.
Yeah. Death saving, exhaustion, and expiration.
And it doesn't expire. It's there as long as you, whenever you want to use it.
Has anyone seen Dobby? I haven't seen him for a day.
Yeah, you know, but the last I saw him was when Fleur and Thanic upset him yesterday.
Nom 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 nom.
Just eating.
She's just chowing down.
No, we're all inside now.
Eating, I think. You ordered.
I ordered for us, but I didn't know you guys wanted it. Obviously I've gotten a good look at that Tiny. What do you two look like?
Sorry, what?
I said, what do you two look like?
Very disheveled.
Mal's got slightly longer hair. It's down in his eye. His belt's, still out. His shirt's not tucked in. He had a night.
Stevie's braid is very much discombobbled, and looks like somebody. Honestly, her hair is down. It is out of the braid. It looks like somebody was running their hands through it.
And the second I see Thanic like looking us up and down, trying to discover this, I'm going to use minor illusion. I'm going to create an image that I've made from the night. Up to personal imagination on what that looks like, but
do you remember, not, I don't know, it seems like weeks ago now, the conversation that you and I had on the road after your little escapade with the twins?
That was literally talking to me.
Have you oh, it was, I thought
no,
that was, like,
that was
it
no.
Bored like 3 weeks ago.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's after. Right. That's right. It took a month to get, yeah. My bad.
And I was good for 2 weeks.
No, that's not good for 2 weeks. That's good for as long as we're traveling together. This is what it is.
Here, I got a different angle if you want to see this one.
No, enjoy yourself. I appreciate it. Enjoy yourselves however you need to enjoy yourselves. But I don't need any part of this.
Thanic,
I didn't interrupt you, did I?
What's wrong, Thanic? It's perfectly natural.
There's nothing wrong with the act. I just don't think I need to view the after effects. If I wanted to see
it,
you mean like this?
At this point, Stevie notices the PowerPoint Mal is projecting. Mal, nobody needs to actually see it.
Hey, what are you guys doing?
Well, you see, if you zoom in right here, and I change it to us making a cake, like very PG. like all four of us are just like baking an actual cake.
Jesus Christ. Yes, I
love minor illusion.
Good to hear something. If I want to see, I'll come look through.
You guys don't need me anymore. I just go.
But no, we should probably go find Dobby. He's been gone all night.
So I had an interesting night. That wasn't what I expected. Not the pole I was trying to dance on before.
Oh, so you found a pole to dance on.
I think I'm very full, and I will stand up and I will walk up.
Not really. Mal is leaving with Thanic at this conversation starter.
Not really. No.
Sweetie, just for the future, if somebody tries to convince you to do something that you don't want, you can say no at any time.
Or I can freeze them. I froze them
or
last night.
Or you can freeze them. Yes, absolutely, sweetie.
That worked out really well.
I'm very happy for you. Use all the tools at your disposal to make sure your no means no. And Stevie kind of walks after Mal and Panic.
Wait, don't leave me!
Come on!
She flies after you guys after grabbing like a fistful, two fistfuls of food. She's like, nom, 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 and she's like flying away with them. She lands back on Thanic's shoulder and eating her food.
Can we mention two fistfuls of food is like maybe one little spoonful for everybody else?
that's like just a hint of cream.
Yeah. She's got her two fistfuls of nom 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 nom.
Mal does want to find just like some random civilian as we're walking and be like, hey, have you seen a very annoying kobold screaming and crying?
No, I haven't seen anything like that. But I did see down the road somewhere there's a hubbub of something about a frozen lizard man that they had to bring.
We are unaware of any
clerics in there to take a look at what's going on. That's all I know.
That's so weird.
Well, if you hear anything about a kobold, look for the horny fellow. And I point at my horns and walk away.
You got it.
Oh, I have so many mouth lines that I have not used.
Oh, shit.
You have only cracked the surface.
Well, it is.
But no, Mal is going to be like asking random civilians until he hears someone mention something about Dobby.
I'm sure Flora's sleeping in. We may as well find her bed.
Yeah, she looked real busy with person looks strangely like Frulum. I don't know. There was a real resemblance there. I think she's a little sad. about...
I'm not going to lie. I used disguise self on some random old lady and did that when she was looking.
Oh, she's not going to be happy when she wakes up.
No, she's going to be quite upset.
If I get bigger, I don't think this is going to work. I'm going to be back in my panties.
Well, yeah, let's go find you. Let's go find you some better sized clothes.
I don't mind this size though, because I can stay on his shoulder. And she cuddles up.
Oh yeah, but we should still find you some more clothes.
I mean, clothes shopping isn't the worst thing in the world. It seems like all of you seem to misplace various garments last night.
Mal's gonna like do that fun old little trick where he pulls a sock behind Fanny's ear.
You're not tall enough.
I can jump.
You're not tall enough. Your arms, even with your arm length, you're like 7'2". That's like my shoulder.
Fine, I pulled out your poulter.
Your poulter.
Oh, we can go clothes shopping at some point in time. There's, I think there's at least one or two more visits that we can make around town. I mean, I don't know what Fleur got into, but if they're going to have their own time today, then we can run some errands. We've got, what, 6 more days here? 5?
Well, I feel like we should probably head over to where Cassian was born.
Yes, but that's quite the trip. How far away is Succumba?
Is it like 2 days?
It is about 150 miles, and the elf, the druid, moon elf, offered horses, I believe. If you need them, they were swift horses. If you were trying to get to Succumba, it was about 2 days there and 2 days back. But they did say that Cassian had just left. But yeah.
I say we get her clothes. We see if we can find Dobby. If not, let's go. Let's go see if we can find Cassian.
And what, leave Fleur here?
Oh, Fleur's right here. She's been walking with us the whole time.
Yeah, guys, listen, I just had a great time last night. I'm just in a great mood, so whatever you guys want to do, I'm in like Flynn, so it's all good. Don't.
Well, very I guess Mal's disguised self lasted longer than I thought it would.
Right, well, if that's the case, then yes, we can go hunt down Dobby, and if we've got something along the lines of 6 days left, we can take 2 days out there. 2 days back, we'll give
may
us...
may not even take 6 days, or take 2 days. We may run into Cassian before then.
Yeah, that's true, especially if we only spend the rest of the morning actually taking care of any business that we have to take care of. We can gain back half a day if we spend the afternoon on the move, so...
At this point, I would like to point out that Fleur had probably used the sending stones to message Fulim about...
That they got some information.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Fleur, I know Sophie had definitely wanted to do that.
Yeah,
and it sucks that they're not here, but...
Yeah. it would have been best if she was here, but... Yeah, but I'm
things were set, and she could open up next week's session with it.
Right, she could just say, "Listen, I don't want to talk about it right now, but I talked to someone last night.
We know who you're talking about.
Right? We'll just leave it there, and then if Fleur so chooses to explain what was said, she can."
Right then. Well, are we going clothes shopping first thing this morning? Or?
I mean, this is very pretty. I like it.
Well, we yes, still you have do something make, else you on make a fair point. I believe I remember you saying that you can't do any magic when you're that small. So we may as well get you something where you're useful if we run into anything on the road.
Yeah, I can't do magic. I'll be popping to Vic, and then I still have my panties. Yay, panties!
Yeah, that's
as much fun as clothes shopping does. You guys have fun. I gotta go pee.
I mean, same. Why did you leave? I also have to pee.
Did he have to pee right before we started? What's going on? How much is he drinking tonight?
I have a teeny tiny bladder.
No, I'm talking about Bryce.
Well, then what, Mickey? Not Mickey, God damn it.
Well, Well, again, let's be fair.
Not your name.
I will tell you why. Because Stevie sounds like a human being's name. Mickey sounds like a character's name. That's why.
One of these days, I'm just gonna break out. Well, so where would you like to go, Michaela?
Especially Mickey spelled the way it's spelled. It sounds like a character's name,
right? So Stevie.
I mean,
if you would like, you can take the rest of the, you can take the girl shopping if you'd like to, and Malamos and I suppose.
I don't think we need to RP the clothes shopping. We can just go get the clothes.
Yes, you can roll to see how well you find clothes.
If you're gonna buy anything from the shops, I would, you know, at least, you know, walk in, say hi.
I don't want to RP clothes shopping. Clothes shopping sucks. Wait a minute. I hate it.
All I know is I had to revolve an entire episode around you guys going to every shop like it was Valley Girls walking down Rodeo Drive.
Yeah, but this is clothes, not magic items, okay?
Hey, who knows? Maybe they sell magic clothes.
What?
Mal walks back up for pissing in the corner. Are you guys done yet?
Well, if you could find white gloves that gave you...
By the way... As you pitch in a corner, you see the proprietor of the inn standing there looking at you and looking at the corner and going, there's an outhouse right outside.
This was closer. and I throw him the stolen coin purse with 4 gold and 2 silver.
Mumbles and grumbles. Gets a mop bucket.
It's fertilizer.
For the sake of staying together, we can travel with you, see if we find Dobby on the way to the clothing store, and then we can all look for Dobby all at the same time.
That would be some sort of dry goods, wouldn't it?
For what?
It's a general store. It's a general store.
Oh, yeah. I believe that's what we'd heard. There's a dry goods store that sells clothes as well.
That would mean that we would go
to Miller's Dry Goods, which is somewhere on this map. Aha, I found it. Carry on!
Stevie's still on your shoulder.
Well, come on then. Pip, pip.
No clothing here.
It's Miller's Dry Goods if you're looking for the clothing.
Yeah, I see. I'm in Miller's Dry Goods.
Sir? Common clothes, costume clothes.
Okay, I see it. Okay, I see it.
I still don't see these banners.
Did you still
try to refresh?
I did. I put a screenshot in Discord. Do you see what it looks like?
Oh no, I haven't even looked. I'm apparently stuck in Fanax voice and I didn't realize.
She's looking at the costume clothes.
Well, yeah, I most certainly don't have those.
Everyone should. They're for all players, so they should all be able to be seen.
Yeah, you gotta like
and closing it.
I did refresh again.
That's weird.
It's all right.
Panic doesn't need to buy anything, anyways.
Okay, so Tiny is still in her fairy because she knows if she gets big, she's gonna like be in her panties again. So she's looking at the costume clothes. What does she see?
Mostly they're onesies. There's dragon onesies. There's unicorn onesies. There's orcs onesies. And goblin onesies.
She's going to go to the common clothes and see what she sees there.
Common clothes, just regular clothing. Unisex. Like, mostly like just, you know, like leather breeches, jerkins, you know, just regular traveling. Just regular.
You said unisex, and I thought you said do the sex. I was like, clothing store, Jesus Christ. This campaign really has taken a turn.
You see Mal walk by the clothes and be like, "Heh, jergens."
All right, she goes to the traveler's clothing and see what kind of stuff they have over there.
Yeah, the traveler's clothing is more like adventurous clothing. It's much more crafted leather pants, and tops and stuff like that. The kind of stuff that you would see adventurers wear and stuff like that. Much more sturdier for the road and fighting.
She's going to go back to the costume clothing area. She's going to grab the unicorn onesie and bring it to Thanic. Can I have this?
Well, I don't see why not. You're grown. Actually, I don't really know if that sentence applies to you. How old are you?
I need to get big in order for me to try it on.
Can I do that here? How old are you?
I think 18 birthdays, but was captured for a while, so I'm not sure.
You're more than welcome to wear whatever you want to, so long as it starts at your neck and ends around your knees at the very least, it's fine. I would say if you're going to try it on, then you'd probably want to go into one of the changing rooms beforehand.
Where are the changing rooms?
Oh, shit, I don't know. This is my first time in here, too. Do I see them?
Yeah, they're quite
clear. There.
Okay, so she takes it, goes into the room, gets into her big stage, tries it on. Does it fit her? She's like 2.5 feet tall.
Yeah, they had children sizes.
She comes back out. She's in the unicorn onesie. I like it!
I feel like it fits your personality.
I like it!
A little whimsical, it's a little childish. Yes, it should be fine.
We gotta fix it though, because I can't get my wings out.
That seems very much like a Stevie question. I mean, I could rip a hole in it, but I wouldn't want to ruin something that you just purchased.
I can't. It's not very comfy. I can't get my wings out.
You know who I bet has a pair of scissors? The person who sells these. You should try maybe going to the counter, since we don't know how much it is anyway, sure.
She goes and tries to
I think she likes this one.
Star Clark.
Yes. So there's a man behind the counter, Miller. I'm sorry, what were you saying?
I was about to say to the guy behind the counter, can we get some sort of way to adjust it for her wings?
Oh, certainly. I can cut a couple holes in there. She would have to purchase them first, obviously.
What is a unicorn onesie for a very, very, very small person actually run?
Well, if it looks at the tag, it's like it's right there. 5 gold pieces for the onesie.
5 gold pieces. 5 gold pieces for something that's got some pink frills on it.
Hold on, guys. I got this. First off, this is a very high quality product. This is clearly worth 7 gold, actually.
It's for small people. The whole point of crafting clothes for small people is that you don't have to put much care into them.
They're trying to persuade you to check Fennec into paying 5 gold.
Persuade me?
I'll pay
3. I'll pay 3 at most.
I'm gonna take it off. It's not very comfy.
We'll fix it if he gives us a reasonable.
As soon as you purchase it, I will put the holes in there for your wings. I do believe when you click purchase, I think you can make an offer. I think
it won't. It won't let me since I don't have the green tags. It won't let me do it.
Hold on, I'll try.
Yeah, you can do it. 3. Malamos, 3.
7.
Should be 3 silver.
Let me
it skyrockets the price because everyone thinks unicorns are cute.
Let me try showing it to you and see or should we just do show to all just to make sure. Can you see anything now?
Stevie's just gonna plunk down the 5 gold. It's the costume clothes, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, costume clothes.
Yeah, so Stevie's just gonna plunk down the 5 gold. Here you go.
Okay, and it's supposed to send a request. There it is. Aha!
Did you wake up this morning and forget what fun is, Stevie?
Thank you. He does take out his shears, and he looks at. He's like, "Quit for me! Quit! No! Quit! Can someone please hold her still? I will cut her wings off if you don't."
Sure.
Me.
takes the scissors.
When the nice man says hold still, cuts, he means hold still.
Cuts one little slit and then opens it and puts his hand in there and takes her wing and just gently pulls it through. And does the same on the other side and pulls her wing.
Careful, she will literally cry out loud, very loudly if you heard her.
Oh, I've dealt with this stuff plenty of times. Just me. Expert hands.
It wasn't bad. It was fine. It wasn't that bad. I was good.
So you're the proud owner now of a
Stevie, have you did you forget what fun is?
Oh, she saw it last night.
I'm sorry, is negotiating at shops fun for you?
It is whatever the price is ridiculous. Won't harp and moan about the cost of a beer if it's in the, you know, couple of silver range, but 5 gold because it's got a fucking unicorn on it. Just because it's the in thing right now. Someone found a unicorn up in the mountains of Xanarok, and now all of a sudden everyone wants to be a God's be damned unicorn. So you're going to charge 5 gold for it. Yes, it's very fun paying fair prices for things. Thank you very much.
It's okay. Teeny's
jumping around. I'm
at last night. I'm fine.
Playing with her new onesie.
You know, I like you a little less this morning. I hope tomorrow's a little better.
Tiny.
What?
Tiny is very, very excited about her.
It's like the second or third last evening joke that you've made. I told you, I don't want to hear about it. I'm glad you had fun. I don't need to know.
She jumps up.
I don't understand why you're so touchy about the subject.
I'm not touchy. But I just don't want to hear about your escapades. I don't want to hear about my noses either.
Tiny jumps up and flies onto Thanic's shoulder again. And
I most certainly don't want to hear about yours because I'm not sure I understand the physics.
Tiny grabs your face and been like, what's wrong? Don't you like it?
Don't I like what?
See? Don't I look pretty?
Yes, I told you, you look just fine. You just look 3 golds worth fine.
I saw some
paint in the corner for like 12,000 gold. I don't think there's any more patronage that this man needs.
Okay, you guys have fun. I'm going to look for Dobby. I was going to look for Dobby at this point. After watching this absurdity for like 5 minutes.
Walking away from the party is my job. You don't just get to take my role.
Then play your role better, Dad. And then I walk up.
Woo!
I played my role just fine. I went to sleep at a decent hour and woke up next to a fucking stag. I think I did dad things just fine.
And a naked fairy. And an almost naked fairy.
I woke up this morning with a God's be damned attitude, and I'm fucking sick.
I mean, you were the only person at the stag party.
Well, everybody else apparently gets shown this great time, and they come up and shine shit on me. I don't get it. Anyway, walk out the fucking door. You look just fine.
Yeah, Tiny Son.
See if we can find Dobby. It's been relatively quiet this morning. Let's see if we can ruin it.
I find another random, like, civilian. Have you seen a kobold crying in a corner, possibly dead?
Let's see
can I
here.
Do some sort of like I don't know nature or survival check to like search for tracks of Dobby?
Yeah, you can. Let me, I mean in the city it's gonna be a little rough. It's a lot of to and fro walking going on, but first let me the guy answers Mel's question. He's like, a kobold, you say? Yeah, I don't see many around here. You know, I do think I remember seeing something that looks like that going out the east gate.
The east gate as in the one to the east, or the east gate as in the east gate to the west?
The east gate in the east.
What kind of question is that?
Mal, did I hurt your brain last night?
I am sick of this group this morning.
Oh, Thanaka.
If we went out the east gate, then he'd be going towards the port. There's only water over there. Shouldn't be too hard to see.
Isn't that the way we need to go anyways?
It is a river. It does the road. If you look at the main map, it does go. The river actually is like
south of Daggerford. Does anybody know if Dobby can swim?
I'm pretty sure he can't.
if the map was out more, that river goes along the eastern side of Daggersford and then turns. So if you've got the east gate and go up north, you can go above the river and travel.
Oh, and that's where the moat and stuff is. I mean, we can go ahead.
Well, the moat is just a moat around a city. The water on the east side, that's the river. But the map north doesn't go north enough to see where the river turns.
We can go out there and look. But
Teeny is going to try really hard and see if she can use locate object on Dobby.
Dobby's not an object.
Wow. No, racist fairy here.
Cole, he's an object of affection. Does that count?
But he has objects on her that she's been close to. So she's trying to locate.
I think it's an object you have to, like, be very familiar with. Let me read Dobby's staff.
Describe or name
an object that is familiar with you. I don't think you're familiar with any of Dobby's possessions.
Unless it's his staff, that little man carries that everywhere.
No.
Tiny's been traveling with us for, what, 3 weeks now? Four?
She's been at least a month.
I'll say this. Roll a d20 to see if you paid attention enough to know Dobby's staff well enough to use the spell.
Okay. So
let the gods decide.
Come on, Odin. Come on, Allfather.
You know something about living
in someone else's pocket?
You know he was holding some kind of stick, but you don't recognize it enough to be able to locate object.
Okay. Well, let's go out to the port and see what we can find there.
Come on, Vanek. You and me can walk ahead and talk about your feelings. Clearly, you need to talk about those today.
I need to talk about anything.
I throw a rock at Vanek's armor.
Look, you saved that bullshit for the road. We don't do that in towns. We're civilized in towns. You act like whatever heathen you want to when we're traveling.
All right, can I do a check to see if I find sign of Dobby?
Yes.
What would you like? Nature, survival?
Tracking, I believe, would be survival.
I can assist for advantage if you'd like it.
I might just have an advantage from ranger bullshit.
It's your favorite terrain just outside cities.
I don't think I think I changed favorite terrain for something else.
Yeah, the only thing that would give you advantage for tracking right now is if your favored thing is... Are kobolds even dragons?
No, favorite terrain lets you double your
position. No, they're their own...
They're under humanoids.
Yeah, you're thinking...
What is Deft? It's Deft Explorer, which it doesn't allow me to fully see in...
You are an unsurpassed explorer and survivor.
Yeah, it doesn't allow... Like, what does that mean mechanically?
On your travels.
What does it mean mechanically? It says,
and in dealing with others on your travels.
Give me a second.
What? Never
I think
heard
it could
before.
Just very well apply.
Right. Choose one of your skill proficiencies. So that's just
You have nothing mechanical.
My proficiency bonus for any ability check I make that use that skill.
So you don't have anything that's giving you advantage on this.
Unless it's me assisting, using the help action.
Sorry, I had a sneeze and it didn't come. Anyways, okay, advantage on nature because Thanic is helping me.
Oh, not on nature, on survival. I can't help you on nature. I don't know shit about plants.
I accidentally rolled nature, but my bonus to survival is a plus 5 instead of a plus 6, so it's a 21 instead of a 22.
Okay. Yeah, I would say you notice kobold-like footprints that match Dobby's gait. Going north following the river, from where you're at, you know, the top of the map is about 300 feet. So you notice it going off, you know, that whole direction. You know, about a quarter of a mile up, the river does turn to the east. So if anyone traveling that way can either continue north, go west, or go east around.
And that's over to Succumber, which is where we were heading anyways.
If you're going east, yeah. If you follow the river and turn east, yeah.
So the elf lady, she said we could have some horses, right?
Indeed. Does it seem like he's heading in the same direction we were going?
So we might as well go grab the horses from her to see what we can do.
We can. Is there anything else that needs to be done before we go? I mean, we can assuredly leave this morning if we need to.
I'm okay with leaving town for a couple days. You know, don't need to be seen too much. Mal's not going back in that town now that he's left until those horses get here.
The horses, you can. She gave you a free rein, basically, to go to the stables. Just give them her name, and you can pick up the horses.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
Well, let's get some horses.
I believe there's actually stables
the
marked on the map too.
I'm looking for them. It's 25.
Mal goes to the stable and gets a horse.
Yeah, on the outside of the city.
Stevie does not need a horse.
It's right by this temple that you were at.
You're telling me horses can't ride horses.
Can Thanic ride a horse? That's a question.
I mean, it has to be a pretty stout horse.
Clydesdale.
Yeah, Clydesdale. Yeah, I was going to say.
Right. I'll take a Bud Light as I go, thank you. I'll tell you what, I think the one thing that I'd do before we leave, since it's real close anyways, I'd like to stop by the smithy. If you want to pop open for me the smithy table, then I can take a peek and see if there's anything I want to grab before we go.
Oh,
see how much
it only, oh, it only opened up the one, it didn't open up all of them? Okay, fine.
Right.
Yeah, I don't know why with you, like everybody else automatically saw it, you didn't, I don't understand.
It has you have to have the book, you have to click the journal notes button. It's the thing that looks like the bookmark tab, like when you're bookmarking things, it says journal notes.
You're a bookmark tab.
It's yes, I am. It's right under the pencil.
But I did it to where everyone can see it, so.
Quick reference for you and
there you go. Fair fucks. I can at least pull it up manually. That's a good point. That'll work. Absolutely.
I'm clicking show to all on all of them, so you should see all.
Why the wizard? Why are you showing?
Oh, okay,
the
you did that.
I'm just doing that so. Just
lizard
so
gizzard, isn't that where Tiny was?
Maybe see the stuff. I don't know.
Thank you. There's nothing.
I mean, you didn't catch mine earlier, so, you know. Bryce did, though.
Yeah, unless I want hand axes to throw at people, there's not much here. Is there one of these other shops that are relatively close by? Take a look at, no. And also, no. Don't want to go visit the jail.
Oh, Thanic, I have a quick question. I have a question for you, Thanic.
Sure.
Do you think you can find use of this? You like to use shield and shit, but you haven't been able to because you're using a big axe, right? And I'm gonna pull out my plus one rapier. Do you think you could use this better than me?
I hold the entirety of the pommel between essentially like two fingers and say, you know, it might be a little small for me.
I pull the handle and it gets to the size of his because, you know, it's technically a magical rapier and it grows the size.
You know, while I appreciate this, there's a certain degree to which I'm afraid that if I were to put a shield on, everything would start rolling natural 20s against me. and I'm not super interested in dealing with that. So while I appreciate the gesture, I think this axe of mine, it's growing on me.
Yeah, figure out offer. I appreciate it.
Yeah, I enjoyed a little bit of the sword and board there for a while, but ever since I've really gotten my hands on this, it kind of reminds me of home. A little. Don't get me wrong, I won't be trading in my armor for anything, but this feels a little like family.
Why, Tiny, why are you at the strip club again?
No, I'm not.
You never left, is what happened.
I'm not.
Oh, no, she
I just...
left. I found her on my shoulder this morning.
Yeah, I'm not. I just
let's put you with everybody else here.
Yeah. where are they anyways?
If I were to drop by the Sword Coast,
I was moving
Trainers
you already.
Bank, would I be able to invest in any stocks in the city?
Stocks? I don't think there's a mercantile exchange in there.
There's a stockades. That
feels more like a Neverwinter Waterdeep kind of thing, bigger city kind of thing. There is a bank here, yes, but I think it's more for small loans and trusts.
As we're outside the city on our horse's runway, should we rob the bank when we get back?
Ooh. I know exactly. I know exactly what I'd like to do with my remaining time in the city, and I would like to go here, just briefly.
Where is here?
It's the Shrine of Tempest.
Shrine of Tempest.
Well, we'll wait for you while you're doing your Tron thing.
I'm not. Oh, maybe we'll talk about that on the road.
It was funny because I actually just looked up that one last night, so I knew what it was.
Yeah, I didn't even see that one over here. I like to go visit churches.
Apropos for Thanic.
I think so too.
Yes.
So yeah, yep. Other than that, I will I won't spend too much time there. We're all trying to leave. I'm gonna spend 20-30 minutes.
I mean, were you going to try to talk to anyone when you're in there, or just take a look around and leave? Or
I mean,
do the RP.
I don't think so. I enjoy just visiting churches, but sure, I can speak to someone. Seem to be any sort of priest-like figures in here, someone who might be knowledgeable.
There are clerics, but they're it's not like you're. Normal ones. I mean, there's stalwarts, which are priests, but they wear a chainmail. It's not like regular priestly garbs. So there are you do see a stalwart there near the altar, wearing his chainmail. There's a few acolytes going around. They're the lowest in the hierarchy. They have like leather jackets and baldrics on. So that's what you see kind of inside there.
Excuse me, this may be the first time I've ever visited a Shrine of Tempest. I don't know if you can tell by my general outlook, but this seems like someone who might be along the lines of what I might be interested in. I'm not trying to join or anything along those lines, please don't take it that way, but I'm interested. I've not quite seen a god much like this before.
Well, are you talking to one of the acolytes or the priest?
Probably the stalwart.
Okay. Yeah, so stalwart goes, well, welcome! Welcome to the Shrine of Tempest. You look like a hardy warrior, like other followers of Tempest would be. Faerun was a violent land, and thus, from sheer number of worshippers, Tempest was one of the mightiest deities in the realms! Nearly everyone who drew a sword or knocked an arrow had fought alongside a cleric of the Foehammer, and just as many had fought against one. Temples to the Lord of Battle looked more like military fortresses, as you can tell. It's not your normal kind of temple. We're very fortified. It's more about the hardiness and defensiveness of battle. If you go out back, you'll even see barracks, mess halls, armories, and training grounds.
Is it true that there's almost like a force that lives here? I've seen many clerics take part in battle and pray to their gods and lend their skill set to, you know, all sorts of battlefields across the Faerun, but based on what I know of Tempest, despite the fact that I've never lived here before, it seems like you almost organized. Do you sell yourselves out to anybody who needs assistance in terms of, you know, military strength?
Well, we have three basic tenets to our dogma.
Fuck, be you fearless. Did your reading.
Be fearless, never turn away from a fight, and obey the rules of war.
Aren't the first one and second one similar?
Well, no. There's many reasons why someone would turn away from a fight. It doesn't necessarily mean that they're scared. There could be many reasons to turn away from a fight.
They sound very similar.
But to never turn away from a fight.
Never.
There's a certain degree of, I don't know. At least in my experience, it seems like there's a certain degree of negligence for strategy in never turning away from a fight. But I can appreciate.
Are you calling our god negligent?
I'm not calling your god negligent. I'm saying,
might be kind of dumb.
I'm saying
though.
That followers not
dumb.
No, followers not turning away from battle whenever the tides are not in their
favor. Yeah, don't they? By the way, he's
negligent. The stalwart's kind of like not even looking at you anymore. He's looking at the fairy who called. Who's
on his shoulders? He's on his shoulders. By the way,
you're 6 times taller than she is.
Never turn away from a fight.
I mean,
if you like, if you know you're gonna.
Mal walks in, grabs Tiny by the wings, and just walks away with her.
I mean, if you're saying never turn away from a fight, she is traveling with me, so
she is going to fight him like tooth and nail, like she is.
He kind of claps you fighting. On the shoulder, and he's like, "You are indeed someone who would look like a hardy warrior and a faithful member of the following of Tempest. However, my friend, I think you have much more learning to do in the art of war and dedication to the art of war before."
Interesting. I think that's a little bullshit. But to each their own.
Do you spend every waking hour thinking about battle? I think not.
What do I look like to you?
Exactly. Dedication.
I'm dressed in better armor than you. This is all I do.
Traveling
all
with
the
fairy
time.
In unicorn onesie.
It's a protection. Also, it's cute. If you can't see the cuteness in that, don't get me wrong, it's only 3 gold cute. But it is cute. It's not to say that. My whole job is to protect her.
The smart man doesn't need to fight.
He just takes a deep breath and he's like, Tempest thanks you. Have a good day.
Perhaps I'll come back when there's a slight amount less chaos going on in here. And I will like walk up to like one of these hulking, like massive, like statues of Tempest that are in here and just sort of regard it for a moment.
He does kind of laugh when you say that. He's like, you understand Tempest was a being of chaos, right?
That's pretty much why I don't like him. This is so close to what I would be interested in, and yet the implied nature of the necessity of chaos, the never turning around from a battle. Don't get me wrong,
Never turning away from a battle gives you liberty.
I have over 30 years of experience in this field.
To live with the excesses, whether it be love for food, drink, hunting, or our greatest passion, battle! Battle! The acolytes, battle!
I just sort of regard everyone and say, you know, maybe I'll come back when you've matured.
I think they're dumb.
Well, Fanix,
they're not dumb. Are they mostly young folks that are around, like
you,
young?
You do hear a bunch of short swords being unsheathed at this point.
I mean, you may certainly try, but I'll save you the embarrassment.
As soon as Mal just started hearing everything from inside.
Tiny, not you, right?
Oh, I know, but it's very much you fuck with her, you fuck with me.
Yeah, I know.
Really a terrible idea.
Yeah. As soon as Mal heard everyone start going, to battle, he's like, fucking fanatics.
Look, there's nothing wrong with having purpose and cause, even though there's a certain degree of misguidance with the necessity of battle and the huzzah, we're going to fight to win and these sorts of things. There's a certain amount of drive to these sorts of people and a purpose that's to be respected, I think. It's not
for me.
They're not dumb. They're just imagine if you've only ever received a certain set of ideals, or if in a time of need, a certain set of ideals helped you move out of a situation that you needed to be moved out of. You would cling to those ideals. There's nothing wrong with this. At least in my experience, there's nothing wrong with
this. I cling to the light.
Well, you cling to me.
It kept me going in my dark days. Light's good.
It did, but think of it this way. You were in a cage, and then you were rescued. You stayed with those that you were rescued with, correct?
Yeah, I like you.
So
guys.
What if you were? So what if you were rescued by a god, who showed you ways to be strong, or ways to be wise, or ways to be cunning, or ways to be sneaky and tricky? What if you were rescued by a god instead?
I was rescued by a god. She's light.
Well, you don't have to speak it for her that way. She already has too big of a head on her shoulders. She doesn't need any assistance thinking since she's bigger than what she is.
She saved me.
She did. And then you cling to her. I think that's just as respectable as what those men and women there are doing. I think
y'all are talking about two different things.
Oh, I'm just prattling on. This is history.
As much as I love, as much as I love a good old Sunday school session, it's not Sunday, and I don't.
No, it's not Sunday, and I'm not religious. Again, I don't prescribe to any of this. You missed my trip to the other temple. That would have been right.
I think you mean, what is it, Lathander?
Yeah,
rather than Sunday.
Lathander school.
Well, depending on who you speak to, it's either Lathander or Amanatar. One of them I'm comfortable with.
You definitely do not look like an otter.
No.
More of a bear, I think.
I have dealt with some bears. He's not a bear.
There are... Tiny... I don't feel like I have the hair for a bear.
Tiny is now on Bryce's back.
What is this Bryce's makeup?
Mal.
Sorry. Mal's back.
I'm going to tell you right now, you're not going to stay on there very long, and I throw her off.
Stevie catches Tiny. I assume she's still small.
No, she's in her big size right now.
Still.
Not only that, but Malamos is very weak. You jumped on his back, and he immediately goes, "Who?"
Yeah, Mal. Yeah. Instead, I thought you were tiny. You know, if you're full size, you jump on Mal's back. You're not gonna be there long, and he collapses on his back, lands right on you.
That's funny shit.
And on this note, let's go save a kobold.
Yes, we have quite a bit of traveling to do. I can teach you a few things.
And I have scary
about religion and its benefits and these sorts of things. We have quite a bit to talk about. 2 days is a lot of time for me to discuss.
Tiny decides that she's going to ride Mal somehow. So she's going to keep
I don't like the words that you said in the exact form and fashion in which you said them.
You have three warnings before you get stabbed by a different type of rapier.
Oh, away. We have horses. Drive, please.
Get on the horse.
Mal, you can't fuck everyone in this group.
Tiny, you see how they're riding on horses? Do you want to hop on my back?
Yeah!
Let's go! And, like, Stevie, like full out trots for a little bit to, like, give Tiny, like a fun little ride.
We find a horse big enough for me.
I think you have to roll for it.
Do we find an ox?
Almost.
I know a place.
There's only one way we're getting there on time, and it's if they have one of the largest war horses available for rent. So we can definitely roll for that if we need to.
No, I would say yeah. Those horses, you know, all the different types of horses you would need available to you are there. So that's not.
As I hop on mine, you just hear like a.
Is that a fucking moose you're riding?
You know what? I think I actually would look rather dashing on a moose.
Moose are giant.
They're giant.
Fucking massive. I have
mooses.
A
moose head.
Don't you say the cursed word meese.
Mice.
Meeses.
It is my life goal since moving to Maine. Like, I need to see a moose. But apparently I need to go farther north into the county.
I went to the boonies.
So the question, before we jump into the hunt for Dobby, is it a good time for a pee break?
Always a good time for a pee break. Just be like me. Wear a catheter all the time.
Yeah, I would say this is a good time for a pee break. So we can take one now, if you guys.
Okay.
So we'll be back in a little bit.
Let's make Fleur kill Bobby possession.
Wow.
Jesus.
And we're back.
Welcome.
What is that audio?
That was the Viking sound.
That was the something.
That was the Viking sound.
Where are we?
What music did I have for this? You guys just left. This is the river just
there's
north.
There's the
of
cabin.
Here. Why is it going again?
No, no. But the cabin's over there. If you guys see the.
I don't have Mickey. I'm gonna reload again. I'm sorry.
Yes, do that. Let me find.
Yes, be offended by technology not wanting to listen to you.
Here we go.
It is. I'm offended when
anybody doesn't want to listen to me. Okay, everyone should listen to me all of the time.
Who the fuck is Mark? Okay. Hello, sure. I can see you.
I'm part of now. Okay.
You're all better now.
All right. So you guys left. You just left Daggerford. You followed that river north, the quarter mile or so, and it curved around a bend. So you're just not even half a mile outside of Daggerford.
Following that road east. Again.
Back to the cabin.
We're looking.
Well, no. The map looks the same, but it's not. It's. Okay.
We're looking for a cold.
Have you ever played a side-scrolling game that is basically one screen just moving continuously? That's what's happening here.
Oh, look at this completely unique river we've never looked at before. Oh, this is beautiful.
It's Daggerford Trail. Who's
listen,
getting dysentery?
You guys haven't seen the maps coming up. Trust me, I have a lot of unique maps going, okay? Every now and then I have to refuse a few.
That's fine.
As long as we stop role-playing for like 5 minutes, we could see them, but...
All about that role play.
Oh, we know mommy's.
But yeah, so you guys are you guys are making your way east along the river, and if you look at the main map I have there, the road to Daggerford map, it shows you that river pretty much takes you all the way to Succumber. So if you follow the river, that takes you all the way in that direction. So you guys are all good with that. You are. Why does it not have an icon? That is dumb.
The road from Daggerford disappeared for me. I'm going to reload.
Yeah, it actually did for me, too. That's super weird.
Oh, hold on a second. I know. It might be... Was it there before, or...
It was there.
I was looking at it, and then I went to look at the Daggerford map, and then by the time I got there, it disappeared.
Okay,
so we want to use the east from Daggerford, right?
I did change the thing. It has menu drop-downs now. So on the road, all the maps that we're using right now are in that on the road tab.
The on the road tab is not there.
Yeah, not anymore.
I've got Daggerford, Faerun world map, and then road from Baldur's North, and that's all I got. Yep. It was there, and then as soon as I switched back over to the Daggerford map, it disappeared. I see you wagging your finger. I got you, girl.
That was a yes. That is exactly what I was about to say.
I got you.
Well, maybe if you guys didn't click out of it, that's your
fault. Well, fucking maybe I want to go look at other maps, dude.
No, I don't see it either on my. On my share map either. I don't know why. Hold on a second. Let me check something here.
This
oh, okay.
It's new software.
There you go. Now it should be there. If you reload.
Maybe.
Daggerford, right?
Road to Daggerford.
I have Daggerford.
That stinks. It was a really pretty map that was super unique.
No way.
I have Dragonford. World map.
Race disappeared for some reason.
World from Bogginger.
His computer might have crapped
out.
Why
is it not there? That is weird.
Especially because it was there.
Oh, come on, man. I saved it. Let me save it again. Okay, now it should be.
There it is. I see it.
Dragonford.
Hey, there it is.
Oh, that's no road to Daggerford. That's a big map.
Yeah. But
it's
that,
not
but
the
is,
one with
what
the
else?
Cabin.
Yeah, but we no, can actually no. see where Succumber is this time.
Right, that's but fair. Yeah, if you could just follow, yeah, if you just follow the river, like I said, it just takes you right to Succumber.
And then on the road, I think is the one that we're missing, where we were all zoomed in on the place.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Where?
Oh, yeah, that one's missing
where
now.
Where did Ice go?
Hmm. I don't know. He'll probably be back.
I'm sure.
Okay, there we go. He's from Daggerford. Why? Okay, I saved it. Why is it? Bitch, come on. No, not GM only. Save changes.
Eastern Daggerford. I see it.
It's like I gotta do it twice for some reason. I don't know why.
Nice. There's a thing. Yep, there it is.
There's a thing there.
Yeah.
What is that?
What are you?
I don't know.
I'm going to kill it.
Yes.
But why are you back in Daggerford, Mickey?
I'm in East from Daggerford. That's
yeah, what now. Oh, well, Now it moved. Okay. It had your little M name next to it, so it looked like you were there.
It might have been Marie. Right. Because she's also possibly. M. Although I think possibly. She might be pink.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, what are you doing?
So yeah, so you guys are making your way east along the river. You see a few commoners just kind of walking back and forth too, traveling along the way.
Mommy, Stevie, can I take my onesie off and go swimming?
Just stay close, and that sounds fine to me.
But my onesie will get all wet.
Yeah, no, so you can take it off and go swimming. Just stay relatively close to us.
Okay.
Well, and keep along with us.
I think my only worry is that I do believe you'll be fighting the current. So, like, be careful, but also you seem pretty small. I don't really know how well you can be against the river current.
At that,
I'm a very good swimmer.
Stevie takes.
I believe in you, but I will jump in that river if I need to.
Stevie takes a length of rope and like ties it around Tiny's wrist, or waist maybe. If this way. You can travel along with us, and I can even pull you, and you can just like float there. It'll be fun.
That does sound like fun. Yay! So she takes off her onesie and puts it in your bag because she doesn't have a bag.
Yeah.
Yeah. So she's gonna put it in your bag, and she's gonna be in the water since you guys are following the stream.
I'll continue along. What do these commoners look like? Do they just traveling just along the road?
Regular folk, just kind of walking to and fro. Some are coming towards Daggerford, some are walking away. Nothing outstanding about them, just normal people.
Good day.
Hello! Thanks, Tempest!
No, thank you. I visited your shrine. Very angry people.
You do walk up. You see a few of them. One of them looks quite frightened as they're kind of walking along.
Oh, which one looks frightened?
We will say this one right here.
Oh. Excuse me as I travel ahead of the rest of my party. Is everything all right?
No, I'm here.
Traveling with you. I don't know. I'm telling you, I was coming from the east. I swear I saw a dragon flying overhead.
A dragon?
I don't know if my eyes are deceiving me, but I swear I saw a dragon.
Is it a big dragon?
They're all big.
It might have been a little dragon. I got a little dragon.
Can you describe it? Did you notice its color? Was it very high up in the air? Was it swooping down low?
It was hard to tell how high it was, but it did seem to have a metallic look to it.
Hmm. And you said it was towards the east. Was it anyone in particular? Was it near Sycumba? That is where we're heading.
Sycumba's a ways away from here, but I saw it about, 30, 40 miles back.
Sure.
Flying easterly.
Well, we appreciate the heads up. We'll make sure to keep our eyes out. Nobody wants to have the day interrupted by a dragon who decides to go from flying high to flying low, as they say.
I want to see a dragon I can ride on its back.
I mean, I don't think most. Mickey's the God damn it.
Well,
the horse is the expert.
There are some dragons that may be nice and good to talk to. But very few of them, I think, would be willing to let you ride on their back.
There he is.
I can be.
Unless you're a centaur. Yeah, sorry, I heard they offer rides to centaurs.
I could be a horse. I want to ride a dragon. He's being
a little bitter.
She had a dragon boyfriend.
Not necessarily a boyfriend, but
sugar daddy is the more proper term.
You're not far off, Mal.
I would prefer to consider whoever it was a boyfriend. You said it was Xeraxis.
Xeraxis, yes.
I've actually been meaning to ask you. Things are just popping up all over my computer screen. I've been meaning to ask you. How is it that you actually feel about Xeraxis potentially being up north in this castle where the rest of these things are caged? I mean, based on what you said, it seems like you've had just recently broken things off with them. Does your heart still yearn for this copper dragon? Do you still have some kind of kinship for it?
There was never really much romantic entanglement, and it was more of a mutually beneficial, fun thing. And she got to ride on him.
Mm.
In a manner of speaking, yes. He's actually the one that directed me to investigate the happenings in Greenest and therefore become involved in your party.
I want a dragon boyfriend then.
I know this wonderful fellow named Cassian.
I can speak Draconic.
And that'll help a whole lot, sweetie. About how I feel about Xeraxis being caught by the cult. That's not a good thing. He's a very powerful individual. And if the cult has managed to contain him in some way, that's not a good sign.
You've known a few dragons. Is Xeraxis one of the more powerful ones based on those that you've met?
Loga. I mean, I would say yes, but like
is there
a hierarchy based on color of dragons?
Not a hierarchy.
Gold. I think gold's the strongest, followed by silver and bronze.
Yeah, I mean, if you're talking about strength, that's something. But strength is a different thing. But hierarchy. No,
that's what I meant. Like strength, like does strength? It go based off of the color?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I would. Copper and brass are usually smaller and not as strong. They're near the
bottom. Well, you see,
again, they are dragons. Still, we're not saying they're weak, but if you're comparing the gold and silvers,
they're a beta,
comparatively speaking.
Fucking incel. copper dragons are generally a little less big and strong compared to, say, a gold dragon or a silver dragon, but it's a dragon. It's the fact that the cult was able to detain him is concerning, regardless. And he was a old dragon, so he had been around a long time, and it's concerning.
Like, for all intents and purposes, this shouldn't have happened, and yet somehow it has, and multiple times over, it sounds like.
Yes, that's it's not concerning for any personal reason, though I am worried for my friend. It's more the implications of having the cult detain and control a dragon in general.
Well, I mean, I think the fact that such things are happening does offer us a certain degree of direction after we get done with this little bon voyage over to Succumber. However, I do worry that perhaps you are right. If they have the ability to sequester these dragons, don't get me wrong, we've all achieved some fairly admirable feats of power and strength and wisdom and charisma, depending on who it is that you're talking to. But I mean, I hate to say it, as confident as I am in my own abilities, we may be in a little over our heads here.
Did Teeny see any of the dragons when she was being captured and detained for however long she was?
The only dragon that was with that camp was Lenathan. You didn't let me know how long she had been captured for. If she had been with them at least a month or more, she would have seen Lenathan, which is the dragon that they all have seen. The blue dragon.
Yeah, the one that was flying over Greenest.
Well, she was captured by the cult. She would have been in the camp with Lenathan there too as well.
Sure.
Yeah, I mean she would have been taken not too early, but she would have been with him for at least more than a month.
Yeah, then she would have seen Lenathan, the blue dragon.
Do I need to roll something to see if she would have remembered or known anything?
No. If you were with the camp, he's a big ass dragon, you would have noticed him.
He's big and blue and dreamy. That's what you need to know.
According to Frulem.
Has a great personality, too.
Well, if there's anything that we can say at this stage, it's only that we can... As long as we're smart about it, we may be able to impact whatever it is that's going on here. Which I guess, like, at some point in time, maybe not now, but I do think that we need to discuss, like, are we doing this? Are we, like, we're making all these travels, and yes, we're making our little side trip to Succumber to find our old friend and these sorts of things, but are we traveling up to some sort of ancient castle to try and free a bunch of fully grown metallic dragons and also fight who knows what in terms of, you know, the higher-ups of this cult, Resmir even, perhaps some chromatic dragons, fucking Tiamat, like...
Oh. I'll be honest, if we can manage this, they have some magic items that, I heard something
spoilers about... Spoilers for the next season!
I'll be honest, if they have any magic items, like Furlong was talking about something called a dragon match, which sounds dope, I want magic items.
That's, I mean, don't get me wrong, there's definitely, I'm sure with a group that goes and steals the possessions of everyone around them, and has been around for who knows how long, there's plenty of things that we can walk away in terms of the spoils of war, but I mean, we are talking about...
This whole thing with them creating these draconians, very, very concerning. We should probably take care of that. These draconians are not within the natural order of things.
That's just racist.
They're artificially
creating. No, trust me, I don't disagree with you.
Well,
what? I wasn't created by two tieflings. I'm artificially created by own serms.
Yes, but the genes
Just be better.
Mal. It's not big enough for you to be this confident.
That's not what you said last night.
All right.
I recall you were on the other side of the room.
All right, that's quite enough of that. Thank you. I'm glad you enjoyed yourselves last night. I'll be happy when we've slept again. We don't have to talk anymore about last night. The last night will have been calm and short-lived and in a campfire.
You know what, Danny? We can sleep in the same bed tonight.
If you guys get into any of that bullshit around a campfire, I can tell you we'll have problems in the morning. But at any rate, again, I just want to say I'm not doubting what we're doing or anything along those lines. I just want to make sure, like, we are... I mean, for all intents and purposes, I have traveled and fought with and seen... great men and women die that are a little bit more, shall we say, professional than this current group. And yet somehow we're the ones that are being attributed the responsibility of going and hunting down what could be dragons. For all we know, this Lenathon, I mean, shit, we could end up fighting him at some point in time. I'm down for whatever, as they say. It just seems a point of order at some point. We should really think about the fact that, like, we are signed up for this. We're not there yet. We're not in a scary castle with a bunch of dragons that are being held by God knows what, but that is the direction that we're heading.
Tiny jumps on Mal's back.
Mal falls on his back and tries to crush her again.
But anyway, enough about it. Enough about sad things. Let's continue on the road.
Yes, let's carry on to death.
Who knows how far I've traveled while I've been die driving? We'll say here. Nope, clicked the wrong button. We'll say here.
So the horses, average horse, you can usually travel between 20 to 25 miles a day with various stops for the horses, but these horses seem very well chained and very trained and very sturdy horses. Not magical, but they almost seem enchanted with the kind of distances they can go. So you guys were able to, by the time it gets to evening, you were able to travel about 40 miles for the day, and you had left actually later.
It was like midday, early afternoon.
Right. It was like at that point. So the evening does arrive. One moment here.
Make my screen dark, DM.
Find it.
I feel like I'm going to be stuck in this voice for most of tomorrow, which is good because I'm alone tomorrow.
No just kiddos?
They're going up to a family reunion, which is, since this is live streamed, despite the fact that my wife will never watch it, they're going to have so much fun and I wish I could be there. But I have work that I have to do and a garage to clean up.
Is this now, like, is that actually going to get done?
Yeah, it has to, or I'll get the shit beat out of me whenever they get home.
When they get home.
I gotta give my share profile a token so people can see that.
By the way, since we're back on the road, rocks are being thrown again.
Tini is still trying to get on your back, by the way. So not only are you trying to ward her off and deal with her, you're gonna try to throw stones too.
And Stevie's going to try and block them.
I'm 100% throwing, if at any point you're tiny, I'm throwing you at Thanic instead.
Look, would you like to become the rock?
She can fly, and she just lands back on you.
Okay, Tiny, it's time we set some boundaries. You know, I understand that you like to you hang out with Fleur, you hang out with Stevie, that's fine. Get off.
Here's the thing. I know we have a largely travelable set of companions between Horse Girl and Tall Boy. I am neither of those things.
I'm quite literally a devil. Don't make me short.
Oh, Jesus.
I like fire. Let's play.
What spells do I have?
Now that we've switched maps. Hello, darkness, my old friend. I missed a joke of some kind.
I like fire from Tiny. Let's play.
Ah, here we go.
Trying to figure out why it's not showing up on my share screen. But you guys all see the new map, right?
Yes, to Succumber.
Yeah. Yeah, yes. So it is evening at this point. It's about almost 9 p.m. So you guys can choose to make camp for the night if you'd like.
I mean, these horses certainly need rest.
Well, and
he's not in there.
Honestly, this might be a good time to stop for the night since we don't have Floor. We don't have Sophie.
It's for now. It's good.
Are you good? For now. Okay. I don't know what you had planned, so.
Should we do what Fanic always recommends and take a watch since it's just us instead of a whole caravan?
You know, we are on a road that's even foreign to me, even in all of my travels. So it may not be a bad idea. Not the.
We
bad
definitely
idea.
should keep watch.
We actually have watches this evening.
You know what? Me and Thedic will take the first watch.
Well, since... Well, I guess Flora is still technically here, sure. You can stay up with me.
And I'll take the second watch with Flora and Tiny.
But I want to stay up with them.
Oh, well, then you can stay up with them.
You're more than welcome to stay up with us.
Do I still have my...
Whatever Mal wanted to talk to me about. Mal never wants to talk to me.
Actually, Thanek, I wanted to have a deep conversation with you tonight. But
that's
I guess
not
you
true.
Don't
More importantly than lying to me or lying to Tiny, don't lie to yourself.
You don't know me. I'm a changed man.
Since when? The last time you threw a rock at my fucking helmet?
No, that's still entertaining. That's entertainment. That's different.
You can get into some things. Maybe Tiny
I didn't
has
think I was that good.
No, that's a... No. Just...
I mean, I'm going to wake up early anyway, so we can stay up for a little while, and then I'll be up for the final watch. Sun comes up and my eyes just open. It's a natural thing.
Tiny is still, like, hanging all over Mal, trying to get on his back.
You know, for a fair, you're not that light, and I'm casting Vicious Mockery.
Roll.
Ignore the commenter behind you guys. I just need to put that on the screen so the map and people what.
Ignore the commenter behind us, i.e. the green box that looks like a silhouette shadow person. Who just got done fighting about
yeah, well, I thought if I, because I have vision.
Commenter walks up, doppelganger!
And if I hide it, the vision goes away. So I have to keep it seen. But yeah. So, what were you guys looking to do?
I mean, I just cast Vicious Mockery on Tiny as soon as she keeps trying to get on me.
60, no damage.
Tiny says,
fuck you and your insults, buddy. She just laughs it off and keeps trying to climb up you.
Sticks I'm so stones small, may your break insults my bones, just fly
you
right
fucking
over.
Asshole. Tiny is still trying... to get your attention.
Can I help you?
It is quite rainy too at this point, obviously, if you cannot tell.
Tiny never put her onesie back on. She's still in her
underwear.
Amazing. Stevie. We went and bought a whole outfit for you.
Stevie grabs the before Stevie goes to bed, she grabs the onesie out and hands it to Tiny.
No, it's raining. It's raining. I gotta get all wet. Put it away. I don't want to get all wet.
All right.
I mean, to be fair, that's actually legitimate. Wet clothes is terrible. That's why I wear my armor all the time. I don't like to have wet skivvies.
Is that rust in the small of your back you can't reach?
There is not a spot of rust on my armor, and don't you say a damn thing otherwise. Why do you think I wake up so early in the morning? I have to keep this prim and proper.
I'm not going to do it. Never mind.
Nope. Nope.
Were you going to minor illusion?
Tiny, what is your... sudden fascination with me.
She starts talking in Infernal. So, I think that you know this language too. So, I'm trying to figure out why.
Mal back in Infernal is going to simply be like, I was born with it. Just understand it. I can speak it. By the way, to you guys, this sounds like, shit.
No, Stevie is asleep, and I'm just sitting here back, like, ousted from another goddamn conversation.
I'm putting up text bubbles of what we say with minor illusion.
Stop, I'm not even interested, and it gives me a great opportunity to get a little bit more ice for my whiskey.
and Sophie, by the way, said, fuck y'all, got out her gear and just, like, passed out. She went to sleep.
Makes
Fleur.
Sense.
Excuse me.
Yep, Fleur. Fleur, Sophie, same person.
Kind of like how Mickey and Stevie are the same person.
I was born
aren't
with this
guys
language.
Usually stronger?
Are you talking to me?
Yeah, I'm still talking to you in Faerun.
It depends. Are you talking about people who actually speak this language? Because they are quite assholes, from my understanding. I am an asshole, but in a different way.
But they're stronger.
I'm an asshole.
Yes, they can be quite strong. I'm strong in my own way.
I knew it. I'm surrounded by assholes.
She's still trying to figure you out. Like, you're a like, curious science project that she hasn't learned yet. She just
I understand. I am quite a fascinating man. I've been called the most interesting man in the world, even.
She keeps
That's why I only drink Dos Equis.
She keeps tugging on you, like, trying to see if she can make you fall over. She keeps, like, tugging and pushing on you. And trying to, like, climb up your back.
This is why I never wanted children.
She's, like, flies up and starts playing with your hair, trying to find your horns and stuff.
As soon as she goes for his hair, he just, like, actually pushes back. No one touches my hair.
She's, like, going
You've
by
seen
your...
one of my rapiers. Don't make me get the other one.
She keeps trying to find your horns. She's, like, very curious about you right now.
Have you not seen a tiefling before?
I have. That's why
then
I'm looking
so
for your
horn. What's so curious about this? They're right here. They're right in my forehead.
And she's, like... She wants to try to, like, trying to, like, touch them and stuff.
No, you've got to ask for permission first. No means no.
But you're not strong. And she's, like, jumping up and down on your shoulders.
You know what? What do I have? Hold on. that won't work. That'll work. Cool. So what we're going to do in this situation, the second Tiny is just not taking no as an answer. First things first, I'm going to use my bonus actions. You know, you really should learn to listen to people, to use unsettling words, using my bardic inspiration. And then I'm going to cast a suggestion. I suggest you sleep the whole night.
What a wonderful thing to come back to.
Can I ask, are you all just sitting out in the rain, by the way? Has anyone made a shelter? Has anyone done
I assume we're building a shelter as we're trying to do this.
Succeed. You fail.
No. Hold on. The cool thing about my bardic inspiration I just used, I get to roll a d8, and whatever this is gets subtracted from your saving throw.
Ha! 7.
Ooh.
So you fall for suggestion, and you, as long as I maintain concentration, you are asleep.
Just like, I think I'm more tired than I was.
Little fist.
I'm pretty sure this all I can make last for like 8 hours, by the way, or 24.
I'm actually not as familiar with suggestion as I thought I was.
Suggestion is a long run. Yeah, you're asleep, so. So me and Thaddeus are taking first watch. I'm maintaining concentration as long as I need to.
Which means that I can't trust any conversation that we talk about, because all you're going to be thinking about is trying to keep the tiny one asleep.
Oh, no, that's quite easy. That's actually
Do I even have your attention? You're not even paying attention to me.
I'm trying to be real with you.
You literally told me about how your armor is prim and proper all the time.
It is.
I mean, it does, you do quite a good job.
I mean, I don't let it get rained on. I mean, well, I suppose I'm currently letting it get rained on, but I certainly don't mind sleeping.
Yeah, but we're setting up a shelter right now. That's different.
Also, polish. I mean, anything metal. If you proper polish, takes care of everything.
You know what? I recommend, and I'm going to say some random ass polish brand, I recommend Minotaur polish. I use it for my horse all the time.
I appreciate your input, but until I see you literally applying Minotaur polish on your horns, I don't believe that's actually real.
I pull it out of my bags, and I pull it out of the vial and put it on my horn. That's what this is.
Can I hand it to me?
I toss him one of my vials.
Just because you put it on your horn does not mean that it's real. And then I take it, just like any sort of ascertaining. Does it look like his snake oil bullshit?
100%.
Oh, even better.
Yeah. It's so literally snake oil.
Wait just a moment. You told me that this helps people get... Is this conversation about to get very weird?
No, that is quite literally just snake oil.
But you said it was Minotaur oil.
Yes, it's fucking bullshit. Like half of what I say. I figured you just picked up on it by this point.
No, there was a part of me that saw you put it on your horns and thought to myself, you wouldn't put something that on your horns that would give you a boner for the rest of this conversation, but apparently I was incorrect. You surprise me sometimes, Malamos. I'll be honest with you, you surprise me.
Just remember, Thanic, I may not be able to hurt things as bad as you, but I can make things listen to what I need to say, and I point to Tiny, sleeping on the ground.
Well, that seems to be certainly true, but I meant more in the framework of, for someone who seems to always fly at the whim that's at their current disposal, you have a certain, we'll say, determination to stick to whatever it is that you come up with, even if it's with very little thought, even if it's with very little consideration for those around you. You have a thought, and your drive to stick with whatever that thought is, regardless of what the outcome is, I will say, not usually beneficial in my respect, but it is admirable to a certain degree.
Just remember, if you don't believe in yourself, who will?
You spend a lot of time convincing yourself that you believe in yourself. I don't necessarily know that that's the most wise way to spend your time, but if it works for you, it works for you.
Yeah, we're not dead yet, are we?
Well, I think that's more to my credit than yours, but sure.
Man, I just had a sudden realization. I had minor illusion, the Fanic game just bodied by Sinereth the first time.
That was one time, and he got his just desserts. He got his just desserts, and you not only witnessed it, but you also assisted, and I appreciate that.
You know what? We're all friends here.
Friends is a strong word, but we are indeed traveling together. Anyway.
No, the whole reason I wanted to talk to you here tonight, and why I put this one to sleep, I want to learn a little bit more from you. You have been of intrigue lately. Because I've been flying by the seat of my pants for years here, and almost died because of it. But then the second I meet you in that burning town, not only does my life simply turn around, but, I don't know. I like your moral stand ground. I'd honestly like to keep... The reason I'm staying with is I do want to see if I can grow from you.
In the middle of this,
a bunch of pebbles fly through by you guys and hit you guys in the head, and you see Fleur in her bag, like saying, "Shut up!" And she goes back to sleep again.
I flip her off.
we can at least attempt to be a little bit quieter. I find that interesting because here stands before me the small, bespeckled, horned man who throws stones at me the entire time we're on the road, and yet you say that you'd like to learn from me. What is it, I mean, in the nature of honesty, what is it that you want to learn from me? What use can I actually be of you other than target practice?
You're a man whose faith never dwindles, no matter how much seeds of doubt I try to plant. I'm not even that confident. And confidence is a big thing I need. I always need it. Never once have I seen you falter from your beliefs. I respect that.
But from what beliefs do you derive from? In myself?
No. Yes, in yourself. You are a man who holds true to everything he's ever said. I have yet to see you go against your word once. I respect that, and that's something I wish to be.
As much as I'd like to speak to that this evening, I think you need to... I think I need to ponder on this, because you are, I mean, don't get me wrong, I don't mind proselytizing whenever needed. I have plenty of stories to tell at pretty much any given point in time, but the prospect of trying to show somebody in your position what it means to believe in themselves is an interesting prospect. What I will say for this evening, I can't remember how much I've told you about how I am the way that I am. I seem to remember a drunken campfire a very long time ago.
Tiny crawls up closer to Mal because it's cold.
Even in sleep. The long and short of what I can tell you, at least this evening, is that if you don't know, I am the last of my kind, or at least of my tribe. I'm sure there are other Goliaths out there somewhere, but the reason, or at least the reason that I believe, that I'm the last of the Thunakalathi is that I, in an endeavor to try and pull my tribe of Goliaths out of their more barbaric ways, I tried to organize them. So when the Netherese came calling with their mages and with their strange gods and strange thought processes, I convinced a sizable group of my tribe to stay back in an attempt to organize against the mages while the rest of them rushed forward, and they were gone like that. And in a fit of rage, those that I tried to organize blamed me for what had happened, and they subsequently rushed forward at a smaller strength, and once again, like that. There's only one of the Thunakalathi left, and that's me. So I can say with a certain degree of confidence that there was quite a time where I don't think I was terribly dissimilar to you. I didn't try and smell anyone's sake oil, so don't you believe that for a moment. But in terms of confidence about myself and who I was and my ideals and what I wanted from this life, it most certainly didn't look like it did today.
Yeah, you didn't try to sell them snake oils. You tried to sell them an idea.
Do you consider that to be what you're doing?
No. Purely what I do is monetary. And it's something I've wandered for many years. And I've never felt quite as grounded as I have since I started traveling with you, honestly. Hence the reason I've stuck around.
Well,
and I'll continue to stick around until I learn what I need to from you.
What I can say is that whether you believe it or not, you may be actually physically giving them something like these vials of yours, but at the end of the day, you are just like I was once upon a time. You're trying to sell them an idea of what they need, an idea of what they think they should want. And when you stop trying to convince those around you that there is worth in you, and you begin to believe that there is worth in you, then there's not really any more need to talk about it. Or at least to sell anybody on it.
Yes, that's plenty of talk tonight. Just know this, you help me get what I needed most, I'll help you get what you need most. I point to that deed of the Delfontaine estate in his name. Whatever you need from me, you have my word.
Are you trying to give me your house?
No, this is fucking mine. Fuck off.
Oh, I was really excited for that. That was a gorgeous house, to be completely honest. I'd like you can to come, settle down
there. Hey, you can come visit anytime. Drinks are on me.
No, I mean, if the deed was mine, I'd be super interested. Not to say that I won't visit, but the deed is interested. Then all of a sudden, we may have a conversation.
I'm saying I'm going to help you fuck these guys up until everyone who killed your guys are good. That's what I'm offering.
Well, as disappointed slightly as I might be, consider for a moment what you believe your own worth to be. Maybe not now, maybe not tonight, maybe not as you sleep, but if you can find the tidbits in yourself now that you believe are your worth, make you worthy of existence, then you have a building block, and it's all time and effort from there.
It's a good talk,
also,
big guy.
It would be really great if you didn't throw stones at me anymore since we're being real right now. There's a certain resonance to the ping when you hit certain parts of my helmet that make my ears ring. So if you could go for like the greaves or for the
So you don't want me to hit you in the chest plate? I flick a rock at his chest plate.
You seem like the part.
You'd rather me do it at the greaves like this, ding.
See, that's better. My ears aren't ringing. It's only in certain spots on this helmet where it seems to go in one ear and out the other and vibrate my brain the entire time.
But I haven't tried the helmet yet. Thing.
No. Can I make a dexterity check to try and get out of the way?
Yes.
Fuck yes! Where'd all my shit go? I have a negative one to dexterity.
I'll send it to you. Watch this. Here, watch this.
No, I got it.
Watch this. But I like playing.
Okay. That is a 9.
That was a fail.
I would say since you're trying to pass it, Mal would have to do a. Athletics, I guess you could say.
Oh, athletics.
Good. Something that we're both equally shit at.
A pitcher throwing a ball and trying to hit the catcher's mitt and throw a strike is athletics.
I'm bad. We're all bad. Not
aim. Oh, you dodged.
Again, all I'm saying is we've just not the helmet. Anywhere else is fine.
Agreed. And then I feel like the rest of the watches us just like casually just.
By the way, that throw, Mal, was like. Like Danik didn't even have to. Danik didn't even have to duck. It just watched it as it sailed like completely off to his left.
Yeah, I'll say casually shooting the shit with a combination of I'm sure considering my charisma, various points in the conversation for the rest of watch where you can tell that I want to just fucking wisdom bomb you, and I'm like. It's not the time.
So how long, because I'm assuming you're going to want to at least do long rests to not have exhaustion. So how long are you guys keeping watch for?
However long is needed. I can pop back up I can pop back up for a couple hours at some point in time, so long as we sleep.
I was going to say, if we do three watches of like, I don't know, 3 hours each, that should be plenty of time for everyone.
Well, you started the long rest. I mean, they started the long rest around 9 p.m. Just before 9 p.m.
So then we'll say so long as Mal and I are in bed by 10, then I can pop back up around 4 and intentionally not wake Mal up, and then sleep for another couple hours at the end.
Okay, so eight. It's Stanek and Mal that are alternating.
Stevie was alternating.
Yeah, I think
when it comes to me and Mal's turn, I wake up naturally because I'm an old man with an alarm clock, and I do not wake up Mal.
I'm gonna say if Stevie's doing it too, that's 3 of you. So that'll be an additional 3 hours, let's say. So it'd be if you do 11 hours, everybody would have a watch, and everyone would have.
Yeah, they're thereabouts. Like I say, I'll wake up for a couple hours just to make sure that there's like that weird middle watch that's taken care of, and then everyone can sleep in a little bit. To make sure that I get what I need.
There is some overlap between Stevie and Thanic. Like they'll be overlapped a little bit.
Yeah, so at this point, it's about 8:30 in the morning. Everyone can click long rest if they want to. It's still drizzling out.
Stevie, are you wanting to do a thing beforehand?
We can RP. You want to RP? Let's RP.
RP.
No, I wasn't sure if you brought that up because there was something that you wanted to discuss or not. I'm good.
Before that, though, Stevie, need you to do another nature check?
There it is. Nature or survival?
Survival, sorry, yeah. Okay.
17.
Yeah, so you were kind of following the kobold-like tracks, and you do notice that they end right about there. So you just kind of disappear. The ground seems very disturbed, but the tracks just kind of dead stop there.
I would relay that to everybody. I assume.
Where is there?
I just drew a circle.
I assume it's like right where we are.
I missed it.
Oh, you guys can't see it. Sorry.
Yeah.
You guys gotta move up a little bit. Since Stevie was the one looking, we will do this.
Okay.
Oh, I see it. I found it. It's here.
So I won't.
Why is it a tiny little circle? They should not be doing that.
I won't say.
Okay. I'm just shutting off the active lighting because it should not be doing little tiny circles like that.
I wouldn't say that to everybody, but I will, like, when Thanic and I overlap. Thanic, I noticed I was following Dobby's tracks from Daggerford to here, and I noticed they stop right there, and they kind of stop abruptly, and that's. A little worrying, just I'll worry that something bad may have happened to him, and Fleur will not take that very well, I think. This is Tithanic.
Well, I will say, under the cover of the evening, not that I am the most quiet individual when I walk around, but if you'd like, feel free to stay here at camp. I can take a look around. Not a long look around, but just enough to kind of ascertain our surroundings, and we can deal with it in the morning. I don't think there's any benefit of under the cover of night trying to move forward and wake everyone up and sleeplessly go forward. I can take a look around if it would make you feel more comfortable.
I think so. I didn't want to alarm Fleur or anything, because I know she is somewhat attached to Dobby. But maybe just take a little look around.
Yeah, would you like to come with?
I think I'll keep an eye on the camp while you're doing that. But just, you know, shout if something comes up.
I can be loud. Before I go, I don't want details of any kind. I just very simply want to ask, are you all right?
Yeah, why?
Because if you're not, then there are things that we can discuss.
You mean the thing in Daggerford with Mal?
I mean, I don't need any details of any kind. All I know is that you're rather protective of him, and it seems like you guys had a very interesting, if not slightly odd, evening, which for all intents and purposes is fine. Things happen when alcohol is involved. I just want to make sure that, considering the usual relationship that you have with him, that you're fine. If you're fine, then there's no need for further discussion. But if there's not, then take a walk.
Well, I'm fine with it. I mean, he seemed fine with it. We're not actually related, and it's a very natural thing.
It is. I'm not trying to take anything away from it. It's just...
Trying not to give details because you seem somewhat disturbed by it. But it's...
No, it's not. It's not disturbed. It's not disturbed. I don't need any details of proclivities that I cannot participate in.
At this moment, you hear Malin asleep go, Steve, get away, you have six limbs. And he rolls back asleep.
I see you interact with Mal every day. And it's very much a protector relationship. I mean, one of the reasons that you and I connect the way that we do is that we take care of these that travel with us. So if there was any issue with the way that anything went down and you wanted to discuss it, then I'd be more than happy to discuss it with you. Again, sans certain details. But if you're fine with it and everything seems fine with it, he seems just fine, even though he's kind of a trash person, which is why I'm more interested in your feelings on the matter. If you're okay, then you're okay.
If you're asking if there was any... If you're asking if there was any magical persuasion involved, there wasn't.
I mean, to be fair, there usually is. So that's for sure. That's it. I don't think that's the whole question.
You're not wrong, but
at least
it was
the high part of the question.
It was something that I was able to consent to. There was a little bit of alcohol involved, as there usually is, but no magical persuasion involved. I appreciate your concern. It was really, there was 50 gold on offer.
He has his heart to heart with Mal the night before, and the next morning he's like, "Did he date rape you?"
not, I wasn't even thinking of that possibility. Now that you bring it up, I'm terrified.
I know he has many potions and oils. Did he slip anything in your drink?
I don't like the liquids that he carries. Let's just put it there.
Let's put it at that.
All right. Well, then, if that's the case, then tally-ho, and I will go and look for some tracks, which seems like the appropriate thing to do right now, because I don't know what to say next, other than I will go do as you asked. And I will, I'll go see, I see the spot that she pointed out. Does it look like if there's a place of disturbance that there are, like, subsequent tracks to follow that may be, like, more humanoid or more beast-like or something that doesn't, no, like, definitively doesn't look like Dobby?
No, the ground, so the tracks stop there. And I would say that the ground for about, about that much of the ground around it is, like, disturbed. Like, very, the grass is all torn up. There's dirt everywhere. Mm. It's very disturbed area.
So I think probably, like, my general pathway, just for reference, is going to be, like, roundabouts here. And then, depending on what I find, I would just end up taking, like a full circle. We'll start here, we'll make a quick triangle, off to the other path.
Okay, find stop there. Great. Stop there.
Okay, stop I'll there. Go back. I'm sorry.
Jesus Christ, you, like, flew off the map.
I'm just clicking stuff.
All right, so, as you are there, the trees right just south of you right here, you see mm-hmm. them rustle and out jump two kobold sorcerers, a regular kobold, and two dragonborn-like creatures. But you notice, unlike dragonborn, they have a metallic tinge to them. And they draw their weapons, and you are now drawn into battle.
This is my favorite situation. 1v5. 1v5. Yes. Are you sure you brought enough?
And I can add everyone else up to the battle as if they come in. But for this it's just going to be Thanic.
We're just going to wake up, and then he's going to get mollywopped by 5 kobolds.
Nah, fuck them. Here's my 2 initiative. 4. I underestimated myself.
Wow. One of mine rolled a nat 1, and another one rolled a nat 20.
So do you want us all to roll initiative or not?
Not yet. It's, when I add you to it, it'll allow you to roll for initiative. Like when I ran the encounters on D&D Beyond, it was like I had to have everyone roll ahead of time because I couldn't add it once the battle started. But in this, I can add people and roll.
I am excited.
All right.
But we should probably wait.
Combat begins.
Till next week.
Yeah, I think we can wait till next week. This is a good time to wait till next week.
Oh. Okay.
A whole one person battle.
Right.
No, he's a fighter. Should, that's what he does.
You guys should watch me as I fuck up this entire group of people. You gave me 2 kobold sorcerers? That's like a 3v1.
Yeah. It's a, yeah, 2 kobold sorcerers, a regular kobold, and a 2 draconians.
Remind me, next week is the 23rd. Is somebody not here on the 23rd?
No, that's...
Sophie was possibly not going to be, but they have said they're fine now. They're good now. They're going
to
be here.
Oh, okay, cool.
I'm going to be gone the 30th. If I have to wait 3 weeks for this
bullshit, I will... If I have to wait 3 weeks to fuck on some kobolds, I will just run a stream session with me and Lunga and fuck these bitches. And that's the only... It's like here. A 45-minute session where I ramshackle these motherfuckers. And then it will end, and then we'll pick up where we left off.
You have no idea. It'll
be like you guys were all sleeping.
I know you're used to kobolds, but you have no idea what these draconians are capable of. Or
I don't give a fuck. I'm Thanic Bridgebreaker, goddammit. I'm here to test their strength, and only when I find out I'm in over my own head will I blow that fucking horn of mine.
Oh yeah, you have a physical regular horn.
You gave it to Stevie.
No, there's two horns.
No, you have the horn of silent alarm. I have the shitty horn.
The regular.
Because I wanted the regular horn, and then Mal bought it, and then we decided to give it to you only after I silently, no, not silently, only after I very audibly bitched about not having the cool horn. Even though I shouldn't have it. It all makes sense. You should totally have it. But at the time, I
wanted the pretty horn.
My first entry into D&D, and to be honest with you, fantasy, because even before Lord of the Rings, was when I was 15 and I first read Dragonlance books. And
then when I started playing D&D. 1912?
Back in 1908.
I have to make old jokes because your wife had the audacity to say, "Hey, the DM has grace. It's no big deal," when you are 53% older than me. So this is I have to regain my
pride. The funny thing is that they're all here. Like in my hair, there's only a few strands. Even though it's dyed purple, it's hard to tell. But there's really not that many. I'm not even barely salt and pepper. It's just a few strands of like, and it's not gray. It's like that bright silver, mm-hmm. like a shiny dude, silver.
It's the gray. Yeah. See, I feel like I'm going to be good up here for a while, but if this has already started, then I'm afraid that like within the next 2 years, it's going to be like brown hair, gray.
Not necessarily. A lot of guys get it in their facial hair real quickly, and it could be a decade before it even goes to your head. That's what he says.
Brown hair, gray beard.
Again, I have three kids that currently live in my house. Brown hair, gray beard by 32. I'm fine.
I'm 100%.
If it started, it's going to rapidly advance.
Dude, I will not know when I go gray because I just fucking dye it. Yeah. I could be graying now.
Oh, I am gray.
Oh.
At least you fuckers aren't balding.
Props to, I will say, just because we're on the topic of gray, props to my wife. She is like almost officially salt and pepper, and it is so fucking cute. I don't understand why. I never imagined that for myself at 30. She even asked me the other day, she was like, "Hey, is this cool?" And I was like, "Fuck yeah, it's cool. What are you talking about?"
Like, I would,
like, she expected some kind of different response. Marie like,
wouldn't want that. She would keep dying her hair.
No, I'm not going to on stream hit on my mother-in-law. What I will say though is that she has been salt and pepper for a long time because she started early, and I always thought to myself, because she's got very, very like dark brown, almost black hair, then the grays. I've always thought, like, man, there's a woman that wears it well. And my wife is like, she started to do the exact same thing. So
actually, let me end the stream here. Thank you all for watching. Until next time.
Nah, let's hear more about how I want to talk. No, never mind. Nope, I'm not gonna say that.